We're all unburdened by what has been. For far too long, federal prisoners were not allowed to get taxpayer-funded sex changes. But that time is now over. Kamala made sure of that when she was California Attorney General.
When I was Attorney General, I learned that the California Department of Corrections, which was a client of mine, they were standing in the way of
please surgery. Subscribe or I'm going to get her to give you a sex change.
For prisoners. I worked behind the scenes to not only make sure that that transgender woman got the services she was deserving. So it wasn't only about that case. I made sure that they changed the policy in the state of
California.
Better
I'll have Michael Obama
fast
come
forward
to your
today,
house.
A federal judge has ruled that an Indiana prison must provide a sex change for an inmate. And not just any inmate. This guy, Jonathan C. Richardson, also known as Autumn Corleone, who strangled his 11-month-old stepdaughter to death. The ACLU believes it's cruel and unusual punishment to not provide this face tattooed baby killer a sex change on your dime. You know what's cruel and unusual?
And you're paying for it.
Baby? Did the ACLU think of that? Remember, Kamala Harris supports this. She fought for it in California, and she'll do it again in the White House. Trump campaign senior advisor Tim Murtaugh joins me now. All right, Tim. I mean, this is radical. It's nuts. We're paying for sex changes for baby killers in prison. What is that all about? Well, that's
what's that all about? Is keep voting for that stupid.
Thanks for having me on here. And yeah, as you just pointed out,
Democratic Party
judge agreed with the ACLU.
That's being nice.
It's cruel and unusual punishment not to have the taxpayers pay for a sex change operation. And as outrageous as that sounds. What's even more outrageous is that that's Kamala Harris's position. And so no wonder that she wants to raise taxes on Americans by about $4.9 trillion because, you know, those procedures are pretty expensive.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what. That's
like
exactly
$100,000 a procedure. And this is voluntary.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This isn't like emergency gallbladder surgery, Tim. You know, this isn't something you need to get rushed to the ER for. This is elective. This prisoner can survive just fine in prison with the pieces they were born with.
Yeah, exactly.
They shouldn't have any privileges.
This is exactly why we have an ad on the air right now laying this all out, laying out the whole case, videotape of Kamala Harris and the whole bit. And it's a great ad. The voters need to know about this. And the tagline is Kamala Harris is for they, them. Donald Trump is for you. It's a great ad.
It's a great ad. We played it last night. And with this country in what? Trillions in debt. And inflation at record highs, we can't afford transgender surgeries for people on death row.
No, certainly not. And that's why Donald Trump was out on the campaign trail today talking about reviving the manufacturing sector and bringing it back to life, an American industrial revolution again. That's what he's talking about. And on the other side, you have Kamala Harris talking about sex change operations paid for by the taxpayers. For people
that's because the Obamas are running the country.
An 11-year-old, 11-month-old
in the shadows.
It's insanity. But that's
and Michelle Obama is Michael.
She in California. She's a San Francisco liberal, Jesse, and she's desperately trying to pretend that she's not.
It's a known fact that Obama is the first gay prisoner, president.
President Harris would be cruel and unusual punishment to the American people. And I think that's
and try to find a picture of her pregnant on the internet.
There's more prime time ahead.
Thank you. Subscribe. See you later.